Today we are going to discuss the topic interest on capital. But before coming to the topic, it is necessary to understand the term capital. We know capital is used to start the business. So if it is given in the partnership deed, then interest on capital will also be provided to the partners. The question arises here, why interest on capital is given to the question? The answer is opportunity cost. Because partner invest capital in the business, but they are not investing this money somewhere else. So the opportunity lost by the partners will be compensated by giving them interest on capital, but it will be given only when it is mentioned under the partnership deed. Now there are some rules for calculating of interest on capital. You can see the rules. First rule is when partnership deed is silent. When partnership deed is silent, then no interest on capital will be given to the partner. Second rule, when partnership deed provides for interest on capital but is silent about its treatment. That means when partnership deed says give interest on capital to partner but its treatment is not given, then what rules are follows? There can be two treatment of IOC. It can be appropriated or it can be used as a charge. When nothing is mentioned about the treatment, then we will focus on the appropriation. Now you can see the treatment. Suppose if there is no profits are given in the question, for example, if losses are given in the question, then no interest on capital is given to the partners if losses are given in the question. Secondly, if profits are given, then interest on capital can be given not more than the profits mentioned in the question. That means interest on capital cannot be more than the profit. Third provision, if partnership deed provides for interest on capital as a charge, that means if it is mentioned in the question that treat interest on capital as a charge, that means treat interest on capital as a burden, then in that case treatment will be IOC is calculated on opening capital. If closing capital is given, convert it to opening capital. Now a question arises, if fluctuating partner's capital is given, then how we will convert the closing capital into opening capital? In case of fluctuating partner's capital account, if closing capital is given, then we have to add drawings, interest on drawing, and we have to deduct interest on capital, additional capital, and profit shared by the partners. If these amounts are added and deducted from the closing capital, then we can arrive on the balance of opening capital. Now, if fixed capital is given in the question, then how we can arrive the opening capital? Suppose if fixed capital is given, then closing capital is given, then we have to add the permanent withdrawals made by the partners and we have to deduct the additional capital by the partners. Now let us take one example. It is given in the question, A and B contribute 50,000 and 30,000 by way of capital, on which they agree to allow interest at the rate of 6% per annum. Their profit sharing ratio is 3:2 and profit for the year is 4,000 before allowing interest on capital. Prepare necessary accounts. There are two cases given in the question. Case 1, when partners agree that interest to be allowed irrespective of profit, when interest is to be charged or treated as charge. That means if interest on capital is treated as charge, then we have to calculate IOC, whether result will be in loss or profit. Now you can see in this question we are preparing P&L account. Under case 1, we have written by net profit 4,000, interest on capital can be calculated as on A and B. A's capital is 50,000 and B's capital is 30,000. We will apply 6% on 50,000, we will get 3,000, and when we will apply 6% on 30,000, we will get 1,800. So on debit side we got 4,800 and on credit side 4,000 is mentioned. So there will be loss of rupees 800, which will be divided among A and B in the ratio which is mentioned in the question, 3:2. Now we move to the second case. When partnership deed is silent about treatment of interest on capital, that means nothing is mentioned in the partnership deed about the treatment of interest on capital. We have already discussed in the rules, when treatment is silent, that means we cannot give interest on capital more than the profit given in the question. That means if the profit is 4,000, we cannot give interest on capital more than 4,000, that you can see in the solution. We will write by net profit 4,000. Now in actual interest on capital is 3,000 and 1,800. We will calculate the ratio of 3,000 and 1,800. It will be 5:3. So we will divide the 4,000 in the ratio of capital, that is 5/8 for A and 3/8 for B. That will come 2,500 for A and 1,500 for B. 4,000 total. That means in case of appropriation, we cannot give interest on capital more than the net profit. This is for today. In this, we have discussed various rules regarding the interest on capital. Hope you must have understood the topic. Thank you. Have a nice day.